Hello, I'm Nathan Judo. I'm here with Wolves supporter Mr. Joe Edwards. Joe, can't believe I'm saying this really. Wolves 2, West Brom 3. That is an absolute shocker. Shocker.
Yeah, awful. Awful all round. Shocking performance. Worst under Nuno for me. I think when you consider everything, the weight of the game, the expectation, the excitement going into it, it was just shocking. I mean, defensively, embarrassing, schoolboy errors. And I know we go on about the attack, and they're not free flowing in attack. Let's not pretend that they are. But they scored two goals today.
Yeah.
The big thing is, if you defend anything like that week in, week out in the Premier League, you're not going to get anywhere. And for now, I think we've seen that a back four has got to be abandoned, plain and simple, because if they carry on using that and carry on defending like this, they'll get sucked into a dogfight.
They're not good enough to play for the back at this moment in time. No. And they haven't, not just at the back, but going forward. I mean, the midfield today, again, got absolutely swamped.
Yeah.
And the frustrating thing is, you've lost to a side that have won one game all season against the bottom club at the time, Sheffield United, who's still the bottom club, and Sheffield United were probably the better side in that game. And yet, look back at that game, looking back at the 90 minutes, West Brom are full value for that 3 points.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Wolves were lucky to be leading at the break.
Very lucky to be leading.
Very lucky. And, you know, Albion, it wasn't a game high on quality, but Albion had that grit and that determination. They put their bodies on the line. They were closing down, in midfield. They were making sure they got the first ball. If they didn't, they got the second ball. Wolves didn't get the first ball or the second ball pretty much all afternoon.
Yeah.
And that was summed up with a second goal, the Ajay goal. I mean, a long throw-in, you don't win your first header, you don't win your second, it loops over Patricio. That was stuff that you'd see in the playground.
Yeah.
It was embarrassing.
Yeah.
And, you give away two penalties. Yes, the first one's a bit contentious, but Wolves have now gone behind, conceded the first goal 9 games in a row. They're 12 without a clean sheet in the league. They've forgotten how to defend.
Well, they go 1-0 down. I mean, Willy Bolly's come back in the side and given away a penalty, although a contentious penalty I've seen. I think it's probably just about outside the box, but it's been given and scored. And look, Wolves should have been 2-0 down as well, really. Callum Robinson, great chance. Patricio spoiled him. Great to see Fabio Silva score. Really pleased for him. I know that he was under a lot of pressure. But like you say, Joe, even when they went 2-1 up with the Bolly strike, going into half-time, you think, goodness me, they've got out of jail here. And you think they're going to go on and win the game, but just a capitulation second half. Connor Cody getting substituted in a black country derby, you know, proud captain, and you can't have any arguments about it. They had to change it somehow, but that just seems like a massive moment, and it's worrying. It's worrying times at this moment in time. And like you say, if things continue, they're going to get in a dogfight, and to be honest, I wouldn't want this squad in a dogfight.
Well, no.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
That's the worrying thing. Because if you've got to roll these sleeves up, I'm not sure they've got the kind of character to do that.
Well, there seems to be a very defeatist attitude among the players. And Nuno looks crestfallen.
Yeah, he does, yeah. Really bad.
Just kind of slumped in his chair for the last, 10, 15 minutes. His post-match press conference, I don't even know if he really knew what he was saying.
Right.
It just almost as if he was kind of
on autopilot,
yeah. Obviously very disappointed, and that's understandable, but
yeah.
You can't carry on like that. There's got to be a way to gear up the players. I mean, he says he's got the confidence in them that they'll turn things around, but yeah, there's something really wrong at the minute.
But he said this was a must-win game. He went on record on Friday in the press room and said this was a must-win game. Not said there's consequences after that, but it's a must-win game for the fans, for himself, for the club. And they've lost it. They've lost it to a side that are still big, huge favourites to go down and get relegated from the Premier League. But that's given them a huge boost as well in trying to get out of this mess. But goodness me, I mean, to concede three as well at home, it's literally like you've had a nightmare. You're hoping it was you're waking up.
A three was probably getting off lightly. I mean, in the last few minutes, Albion were like attacking at will, and there was no. there was no Wolves shirt there, really. Everybody just seemed to just abandon their defensive duties. No player comes out with this. I mean, I'll be doing my player ratings. No one.
You're a player. Don't look at the player ratings.
Nobody any more than a 5. I mean, you know, there'll be 3s all round, pretty much. So, it's going to... It's just bad. It's just downright bad. It's a bad performance. They're in a bad state. They've got to change the 4. They can't carry on playing in a 4.
No.
I mean, that experiment has failed. And, you know, I can see why they tried it, but it hasn't worked. If they carry on with that, a broken system, that will get sucked into trouble.
I think it can work, Joe, but I think it can work when you've got someone like Raúl Jiménez up top. And you've got two proper, you know, centre backs, really. But you can't do it at this moment in time. You can't do it. You've got to go back to it. I know you want to change it, and Nuno changed it, and he wanted to play a different brand of football. I think now potentially the time has come to go back to what you know best. Like you say, that back 5 and counter attacking. It's been successful. It was still successful, I think, when they ditched it. To be honest, okay, maybe not. I understand you've got to evolve and all these phrases that Nuno, you know, likes to use. But at the same time, I think now says, okay, enough's enough. Let's go back to what we know.
Yeah. And, you know, even you look at the defenders, you've got Willy Bolly coming back in, we're pleased to see him back in, but he's just as guilty as anybody else today. I mean, giving away that penalty, he had a poor game,
yeah.
You know, I know he scored
didn't
a
help
goal.
Truro didn't help, to be fair, in the lead-up to it by a complete
mistake. No, it's a silly challenge, so, you know, there's problems all round defensively, and defence is the problem. I think today proves that. Yes, they're not great going forward. They haven't scored a great amount of goals, but, you know, all the talk about, you know, getting a striker in this month and a disappointment of that not happening. I mean, you know, it probably won't happen this month, but summer, centre-half. Got to get proper
quality
in defence, because, you know, ultimately, you've come in, you know, into the Premier League 3 years later, it's pretty much the same defence that was in the Championship, and, you know, some of these players now, I think, you know, showing that more quality is definitely needed.
Yeah, and look, a year and a half ago they were really after Ruben Dias, weren't they? We look how good he is now at Manchester City. But those are the kind of players they need to unearth. I'm not saying quite a Ruben Dias, but someone's going to come in and he's going to play every single week and noisy, and he's just oozes class, because they need that at the moment in time. Look, where'd you go from here, Joe? Obviously, they go to Chorley, look, they've got to win that game, as simple as. And if they don't win that game, I don't want to. It doesn't even bear thinking about, to be honest. But I'm sure it'll be a much changed lineup. But at the same time, they need to get that job done. You go back to the league, they've got Chelsea next. And then they've got Crystal Palace on their road. I mean, it's not easy, is it? Things have got to change, and they've got to change quickly.
Well, they'll be changed at Chorley, but I'd imagine not as much as there would have been. I think there's kind of an onus on these players to, you know, really kind of.
Click,
and
get a good performance under the belt.
Yeah. I mean, even if it's against non-league Chorley, they need it from somewhere. So, I mean, today we all know it's just a dark day, and undoubtedly the worst day of the season. I'd say probably the worst day under Nuno, really. I mean, just you look at the demeanour of everyone involved. They're really Wolves of now. This is the lowest point that they've been under Nuno, no doubt, and hopefully the only way is up from here.
Is Nuno under pressure?
I mean, there'll be plenty on social media. I mean, I'm probably going to stay off Twitter tonight, to be honest.
Delete it.
But it's, you know, it's part and parcel of the job. You know, they're not performing well. You know, his changes that he's made and decisions that he's made have not worked. You know, primarily the decision to go to a 4 at the back and persist with that hasn't worked. I think.
And we all thought he was going to go to a 5 today, didn't we?
Yeah, I mean, everything he said in his pre-match press conference yesterday, going back to the foundation, keeping clean sheets, Willy Bolly's going to play that. That seemed to point to, you know, 3 at the back for me. But he wasn't. I think he's got to do it going forward. He has made mistakes, you know, everybody's culpable of them. He's made mistakes. He is under pressure. But I don't think he'll come to you know, the S word, you know, yet. I mean, he's got plenty of cash in the bank.
They were shit.
they have got, you know, he's got cash in the bank, of course, and but, you know, make no mistake, they've got to be a damn sight better than this. And I've been saying that for weeks now. But, hopefully this is the low point. It doesn't get any lower than this, and we have some better times over the rest of the season now.
Us 2, West 1 3. For all the post-match reaction, make sure you log on to expressandstar.com.